It would have been a good weekend to vlog. I had a bunch of, just did a bunch of different stuff. It would have been exciting, but my batteries were at the shop. And after Saturday, I just didn't want to go back down there. So I didn't do any filming this weekend, which is kind of nice. But at the same time, I really miss like the editing portion because it gives me something to do in the evening times. But Monday, baby, it's a Monday. Last week was just, it was a slump week. I don't know. I got some work done, but I didn't really like hard charge like normal. This week, by God, I got my sights set on a, I'm gonna be building a table. So I'm looking forward to starting that. So I'm actually getting material this morning and get rocking. So that's enough talking. Let's get rocking. Poet. I didn't even realize it. Sawmill doesn't carry any type of cedar. It said like aerator cedar, which is for closets and chests. Talked to a guy that owns a hardwood store. I said, what's the, is there any downfall to buying cedar at just Menards? And he said, no, just check your moisture content. It's an outdoor table anyway, so we're not too concerned with it. But obviously we don't want it to be too high. So right now I'm just looking to make sure everything's flat. We don't have crazy twists, which all this cedar is pretty good. And I'm looking for pith. Pith meaning that. That's pith. That's the center of the tree. That's where you're gonna run into the most trouble with anything splitting or failing. So if I can avoid getting anything with pith and not have to cut it out, that's what I'm gonna do. Everything was pretty dry. It was under 10% on every single board, except for one. It was like 11 on one end. So I'm wondering if it wasn't the end that was sticking out or vice versa. Either way, I'm gonna stick her in for a day, work on the base. I didn't get enough. For some reason I clicked 14, but I only got 11. So I don't know. I'll do as much as I can on the legs and make a trip back and grab some more. Main trick to stickering is to make sure this one's off a little bit. Make sure your stickers line up throughout the entire stack. Now, something this thick and big and as dry as it is already, it's not quite essential, but you want to sticker it so there's airflow, and you want to sticker them even so that way boards don't start to cup and twist. If you're planning on stickering for a long time, actually trying to dry them out, set something heavy on top, get a sheet of plywood or something and get some cinder blocks just to hold that stack down, because if you don't, they're gonna cup and warp. I've had quite a few around here in the higher parts of the shop really warp out where the heat's
dominant. Just a little tip for you. So I'm gonna mock it up. Before I fock it up, I gotta make three of these legs, about 5.5 inches wide. Have a little bit of a, I guess I could show you, a little bit of a, you know, kind of flared out. But I'm gonna make up a little template, and that way I know what to do, because I'm dumb. Been a while. Let's talk it out.
Talk it out.
Dominoes. Dominoes have their place in the any shop, my shop, your shop. Absolutely. I'm not even going to pull them out. You've seen them. They're all over the internet. DF500 or the DF700. 700 is obviously the bigger one. The DF500, you're going to get smaller dominoes like these. There's way too many varieties. I don't know why. This is a 5x30, I believe. The 5x30. Super small. Don't use them a lot. Bed spindles, stuff like that. This, 10x50. This is almost an everyday use for me. 10x50s for cabinetry, 3/4 material. I don't use them as much. Even for cabinetry, I'll still do. Like, I feel like it's just as easy for me to set up a dado blade instead of trying to figure out where to measure these. I don't really use it that much. It sits on the shelf pretty much all the time. The 700 will make this one, which I'm out of, which prompted me to start this video. I don't even have one, but you saw it earlier today. The big domino. I mean, it's like this long, big dude. I'll use that one for breadboard ends. I don't always use it for joinery when you're, you know, jointing two pieces together. I don't always throw one in there. It doesn't add any structural strength at all. It does not help anything pull apart. What it does help is keep it in line. So when I ran out of them, I switched to the 1050. If I'm using it just for alignment, it's the exact same, thing. It's still gonna help keep everything. You know, if I glue up, it's not gonna be like, you know, if I'm gluing up, it's gonna keep everything flat if it's in there and keep everything lined up. So it doesn't matter if it's 10 miles long or 3 inches long or an inch long, it's still gonna do the same thing. So I keep everything lined up. Reclaim stuff, if it's gonna have a lot of twists, a lot of bow, use the hell out of them, because during blue up, it's gonna keep those bows, it's gonna work those bows out of the wood. It's really gonna help you out. So it doesn't add any strength, but by God, they are pretty handy. If you're just doing three-quarter material, I'm sure you can get away with just a biscuit jointer, it'd be just fine. But they're definitely worth it. They're a good machine. They've helped me out a lot. So I'd say if you're in the business and you're trying to make money and save time, well, even with, you saw the table legs, that saved me absolutely hours and hours of time of making mortise and tenon joints, which usually I shoot about 50% on. So that all came out 100%, no slop, no problem, worked out good. So Domino is definitely a good tool to invest in if you're in it to make money. That was a good day. I just kept myself from saying all right, which doesn't happen very often. I was like three boards short. I don't know why. I think I explained that earlier. Something happened with the order, but I really want to get all the tops glued up today, but I didn't. That's fine. I can get it first thing in the morning. It'll be dry by tomorrow, late afternoon. I'll still be able to get the top somewhat assembled, but I've got my three halves, 22 inches wide, so they're going to fit through the sander just fine. There's going to be a middle breadboard that pulls apart so the table can be taken down in the winter time, easier to store. I'm going to scrape some glue and head on home. Oh, yeah.